What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be discussing my strategy for competitor analysis and figuring out, you know, the language, the messaging, the brand identity that other companies are using that are in competition with my product. So I was in a print-on-demand group and I saw someone asking about, you know, what other sellers who were selling metal signs, what kind of language that they were using, what kind of offer they were using, what kind of creative were they using? Was it a video? Is it a carousel? Is it a static image? Things like that. And generally speaking, I always advise that it's better for you, instead of getting your answer in one of these groups, is to figure out how to find the answer yourself. So that's what we're going to go over in today's video. And please, if you have any questions at all for future videos that you want me to answer in a short form video, please leave them in the comments below. Do not be shy. I love doing this. I love helping others out for no cost whatsoever. So please get active in those comment sections and I'll answer any question that you might have on my strategy or something that you're trying to do on your own. All right. Without further ado, let's dive on into the browser. It all starts off with a good Google search. All right. So what I want you to do here is just type in your product in, you know, so metal signs, for example, right? So personalized metal signs. All right. Now we see all these brands up here in the sales. Okay. Then we also have these guys right here that are sponsored posts. Now, if they're running ads on Google, there's a high likelihood that they are also running ads on Facebook, seeing as Google is generally like step two. Once people figure out Facebook and Instagram ads, if they're drop shippers or print on demand stores, they generally do Google next for retargeting, display ads, branded search, things like that. All right. So let's just go ahead and not Etsy or Amazon. Let's see what these competitors are doing down here. We got Smart Sign, Custom Made, Vistaprint. Let's not go there. Marker Table, and that's good. All right, so Shop Metal Signs, this is Banner Buzz. This does not look to be the personalized metal signs that we're looking for, but let's just see. On the bottom, if you scroll all the way down, most people's websites built into the theme, they have their social media links down here. So let's just go ahead and click on some of these and see if we can't find some ads for this company. All right, now once you're on their Facebook page, you wanna click on About. And then under Page Transparency, they're not showing it here. Interesting. All right, so right down here. So page transparency, see all. If you don't find it in the about section, you could probably find it down here on the left-hand side. Go to ads library. They're not running any ads. These are all inactive. So, okay, mark it off your list. Move on to the next one. Smart Sign. Scroll all the way down. We don't have a Facebook link here. Let's see if it's on the about me section. It is not. All right, cool. Moving on to the next one. Custom Made. Here we go. Facebook. About. Page transparency. They are not currently running ads. All right. It's another bad example. Let's keep moving. This is Maker Table. And they do not have Facebook listed here. All right, so if you do a search like this and you're not finding anything from these Google search results, I would just go right into Ads Library and let's just type it in here. Metal signs. And voila. Okay, so High Voltage Custom Metal Art. Let's check them out. Craft My Sign. Let's check them out. Goat Signs. Novels, no. SK Metal Designs. Let's check them out. And we're good. All right. That should give us enough here. So High Voltage, About, Page Transparency. Let's go to their ad library. So we only have three results here. This one, New Zealand made steel art signs and garden decor. Okay. This is a cool carousel ad here. Showing off a variety of wall art. Obviously, these look like mock-ups, I would assume. Going after kind of like a musician, maybe. This one's going after kind of like maybe country pride. This one's going after the American pride, maybe, with the eagle. And then we got some outdoor art here. Phenomenal. I cannot rave enough about custom metal art. Support NZ Made. All right, cool. Let's move on to the next one. Craft My Sign, Page Transparency. Here we go. 26 results. This has been active since March. This is today. This is a new ad they're running. February 27th. Don't miss this offer. 15% discount. Some more UGC here, it looks like. Add a personal touch to your home. With craftmysign.com, you can customize wooden and metal signs to decorate your home, office, ranch, cabin, he cave, she shed, or the den. Or they den. Typo there. Don't miss this offer. So these are probably some retargeting ads right here. The wait, don't miss this offer. If you went to the website and abandoned cart, maybe they're giving you a 10% off discount code here. And then these look to be like, you know, the top of funnel or cold traffic ads. Lots of retargeting, it seems like here. So maybe they're focusing primarily on retargeting. This is ad is active since May. So here we go. So what's good about this is we can see how long these ads have been running and that they're still active, as you can see right here, right? So these ads started running on May 13th and they're still running in March of 2023. So several months have been running now. So we can assume that these ads are probably performing pretty well for them. All right, so the longer the ad's been running, the higher the likelihood it is it's doing its job at acquisition for new clients and customers. Let's check out Goat Signs, page transparency. All right, just one result here. Stop scrolling. Did you forget something? Okay, again, this is a retargeting ad. So most of these metal signs companies aren't really running any cold traffic, which is interesting. But maybe they're getting a lot of traffic from Google. Maybe they're running all of their awareness campaigns and reach campaigns on TikTok, and they're using Facebook to retarget those visitors that were pixeled, right? So interesting. Might be something worth checking out where they're getting all their traffic from initially that they can retarget. Let's check out SK Metal Designs. Only three results here. Metal signs never got a sale. For more than 20 years, we've been making custom metal signs. They're adding this in there for authority. Home decor products, U.S. Steel. If you're into, you know, United States made stuff, USA made. Nothing beats our custom cut metal designs. All right. So, you know, you get the general idea. I'm not seeing anything that's blowing me away here in terms of the ad library. But, you know, again, it's just something that you can check out. So let's take, for example, let's do something else I've seen a lot. So let's just do dog t-shirts. Let's do, custom dog. All right, nothing there. My paw arts. Okay, I'll check them out. Zazzle, no. Poppy, pop your pup. Check them out. Funky t-shirts, Print your pet. Okay, let's check out some of these guys. All right, turn your dog into a beautiful photo. Let's see if they're running any ads. I'm not seeing their Facebook links. Let's just remember this brand. So this is Paw Arts. Let's see if they're in ad library. Boom, there they are. Three follow my 78. Let's check. Let's see, they got a lot of different pages here. One of them is probably running traffic and the rest aren't. Boom. So they're trying to hide it, right? They're trying to hide their ads library from people by, you know, using different names and having a bunch of different pages. But here you go. It's a great example. Custom dog-based t-shirts for dog lovers. Dog photo, name, and quote can be changed. Free preview before printing. We got hoodies, sweatshirts, long sleeves, and shirts as well. Looks awesome. Let's scroll all the way down and see. This has been running since February 27th. All right, so they're fairly new here. But again, they're, you know, this is like the generic turn your dog into a t-shirt, add their name and a quote. And then down here, we're using like the dog father. So they're kind of taking a stock image, referencing a movie, and they're adding your dog's face to it, which is kind of cool. It's a way to, again, make your product unique in some way from the competitors. If you attach it to a sub niche, so I love my dog and I love the Godfather. Boom, here's a t-shirt just for you. Let's see here, pop your pup. Let's scroll down. There we go, Facebook. About Not currently running ads. All right. And then we got a privacy era. Okay, cool. So, you know, the brands that are running a ton of ads, like this example here with Paw Arts, what I would suggest doing also as like an extra edge, because we know that paid traffic is the quickest way to validate products. It's the quickest way to drive traffic to your website and get views. Now, one of the other biggest revenue generators for your website is going to be your email list and SMS list. Okay. So I know you visit websites all the time. I'm sure where a pop-up comes up, save 10% off your first order, 20% off your first order, something like that. So I would suggest signing up for these newsletters. All right. So sign up for these newsletters, start seeing how they're speaking to their audience. If there's any brand identity in there, what products are selling uniquely. If it's unique in a, you know, a sub niche of the general store niche. And just start getting in here and seeing what your competitors are running, see where they're having some success, and then kind of duplicate that. Now, don't copy anything word for word here. Again, this is just a research phase where you're going to get some ideas about some other offers that people are running. And really, it's just a place to kind of give you some ideas of what direction to take your store, to take your messaging and all that kind of stuff. All right. So I highly suggest looking at their ad library, looking at their newsletter signup email flows, as well as their abandoned cart email flows. So as an example for abandoned cart email flow, all you would need to do here is, let's see if they have anything that's not dog mom. Not customizable, just so I could kind of show you this. These all look to be personalized. Let's try this page. Bestsellers. All right, I don't have anything to upload, but essentially what you want to do is add this to your cart. Okay, go through the checkout process, type in your shipping information, and then once it gets to the payment info, you're going to abandon your shopping cart. And what that'll do is get you into their, if they're running it, which if they're running ads and they have a Google Ads up as well as Facebook ads, they're most likely going to have some sort of email flow set up as well in Klaviyo. So again, abandon your checkout. Use a different email, by the way. So one email for newsletter signups, one email for abandoned cart. I will usually do one on my computer for an IP address and device ID that's different from my phone, where I'll be doing the abandoned cart sequences and flows. It all really depends on what your setup is, but get their emails, check out their messaging and abandoned cart. How are they increasing urgency and scarcity to get you to buy if you abandon your cart? What kind of messaging and targeting they're using on Facebook in terms of retargeting, don't miss out on this deal, things like that. And this should generally give you a good place to start. If you're brand new to e-commerce, if you're brand new to print on demand, if you're brand new to drop shipping, or if you're an established brand, it has a brick and mortar, maybe a boutique downtown, and you want to get in the online space, this is a great way to research your competitors, figure out what messaging they're using, what email language they're using, and offers that they're currently running through Facebook ads. So again, Facebook Ads Library, phenomenal tool. Google is your friend. And if you have any questions about what we discussed in today's video or in something you'd like to have answered in a future video, please drop them in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you did get value out of today's content, I do this for you completely free of charge. I want you to have success in e-commerce and break free from the 9-to-5, because that's just no way to live your life. All right, that's it for today's video. As always, peace.